Hello, I'm Gabrielle. Welcome to part 2 of How to Get into Cambridge. In this video, I'm going to guide you step by step on how to answer Cambridge's application questions. I'll share the course structure and the courses that I took, the electives that I chose at Cambridge, choosing college, and much more. Hopefully, this video would help you with your application to Cambridge. I've made a part 1 of this series of getting into Cambridge. I'll put a link up here. Please check it out if you haven't, because it contains important information on how to make a successful application to Cambridge, including the application process, interviews. Please come back to this video after you watch this if you haven't. Without further ado, let's get started. People ask me, why are you making this kind of video? Firstly, it is highly requested. Thank you to my amazing subscribers for leaving kind comments and DMs. Secondly, I have a background in college consulting. I did pro bono college consulting when I was a student at University of Chicago doing my bachelor's degree. Moreover, an interaction with a 17-year-old cancer patient changed my life. I was a volunteer at the University of Chicago Comer's Children's Hospital. I tutor inpatients, math, science, SATs, and other subjects. I volunteer there twice a week for our sessions. One time, I was paired with a 17-year-old cancer patient. He's writing his college application essays and scholarship essays. I helped proofread them and give comments. Also, we looked at his application questions, and I thought this kind of work is really meaningful, and that's why I want to do more through the YouTube platform. In the About You section, there is a college membership subsection. This is where you can rank your top 2 choices of college membership. What does college membership mean to your admissions process? In postgraduate admissions, college preference doesn't affect the admissions result. That means whether you get your offer for your master's degree doesn't depend on which college you apply to in this subsection. However, it is important to rank your colleges wisely, because once they're in a college, they could not change colleges. People often ask me, how do we choose a college? I recommend considering the practical aspects and also the cultural aspects. Practical aspects include scholarships available at the college, endowment, and facilities. There are some scholarships that are only attainable at certain colleges. You have to be a member of the college to apply for those scholarships. Therefore, I recommend looking at which scholarships you're eligible for before you apply for colleges. Second, for endowment, you could check the endowment on this Wikipedia page and sort by endowment. The colleges that have lots of endowment probably would have more resources and scholarships available to its students. However, we also have to make that kind of trade-off between choosing a super popular college and how competitive it is. Third, facilities. It kind of relates to endowment. College facilities could be further broken down into sports or study-related facilities and accommodations. For sports facilities, I could give an example. In Christ College, they have an outdoor swimming pool, which is really, really nice on a hot summer day. As members of the college, you have free access to the college's sports facilities. But if you're not part of that college, you're not allowed to use them. The University Sports Center is not free for students to access. You have to pay a monthly membership fee. That's why having college sports facilities matters. Study facilities include college library, study rooms, and meeting rooms. College library matters because it is usually closer to where you live compared to the university library. A nice college library is attractive if you're the kind of person who prefers to study at a library because it's quieter and it's easier to focus there, just like me. In terms of college accommodation facilities, you could check out this video where I showed the cheapest and the most expensive college room at Magdalen College. Depending on which kind of room you want to stay at, you could check out the college's website to see what rent bands there are available and what types of rooms and what do they look like, where are they located, etc. Cultural aspects include the people and what's unique about the college. In terms of people, do you like the environment to be friendly, competitive, or both? How do we know if a college's atmosphere is friendly or not? We could speak to students from that college to find out. For me, I have a friend from an internship who went to Magdalen College at Cambridge. She's super friendly and smart at the same time. We got along really well, and that motivated me to apply to Magdalen College as my first choice. In terms of how do we know if a college is competitive, you could check out the Tompkins table, which shows the percentage of first-class honors of a college. In terms of what's unique about a college, you could check out its history, traditions, look for events happening in the college on its website. What's unique about Magdalen College is that it's next to the river. In fact, it has the longest river frontage among all Cambridge colleges. This is attractive to me because I'm interested in rowing and river views. The boathouse is quite close to Magdalen College. Also, it has a really nice scenic path along the river to go from one side of college to the other side. Furthermore, Magdalen College is centrally located and is continuous. By continuous, I mean that the college facilities are quite close together, so it's convenient to go from your room to the library. In the About Me section, I want to talk about the academic history because it relates to the entry requirements. So make sure your final grade that you put in this academic history for your bachelor's degree fulfill that entry requirement for degree qualification. Also, just to clarify, degree level education means higher level university / college level education. So there's no need to provide high school education history. Academic awards. You can include up to 5 academic awards in this section. It could be merit-based scholarships, dean's list, competition that you win in the academia, extreme honors, such as National Academic Honor Societies in the US. Moving on to the course application section, there is the reference request subsection. Here, you can ask 2 of your professors to provide recommendation letters. Please make sure that you ask your professors well in advance and make sure that they've already agreed to be your referee before putting down their email and contact details. I asked 2 of my economics professors from UChicago to write my recommendation letters. Thank you very, very much if you're watching this. Thanks for making my dream come true. Employment history. Here you can put up to 5 internship or full-time job experience that are relevant to the program that you're applying to. What is relevant really depends on what you think you learned from that job experience and how you could translate it to your program of study, so it doesn't have to be directly related. For example, I put my management consulting experience in this section because I did work on some technical projects that requires coding, so I think it is relevant to the MPhil machine learning and machine intelligence. In this section, you just need to put the basic title, duration, the company, that kind of factual information. But in the supporting documents, you'll be required to submit a CV where you could elaborate on what you did, what you achieved in your internship or job. English language competence. In this section, you might be required to submit your IELTS or TOEFL score depending on your nationality and where you did your bachelor's degree and how long ago you graduated from your bachelor's degree. You can use this tool to check if you need to take a TOEFL or IELTS test. Other information. It includes CV and a short answer to career goals. How do we make a good CV? First of all, I recommend using the DD resume template. It includes some LaTeX code used for formatting your CV. Second, please keep it to 1 page to keep it concise. Third, what can you include in your CV? You can include your work experience, your academic research, extracurricular activities that are relevant. For example, if you're in like a robotics club, organize some hackathons, you can include it in the resume. Fourthly, you can write the bullet points using the STAR method. STAR stands for Situation, Task, Action, Result. The emphasis should be on the result. Please make sure to quantify the results using numbers and time frame. For example, instead of just saying you increased the revenue of the company, you can say you increased the revenue by 60% in 1 year. Career goals short answer. The word limit is 1,000 characters, which is roughly 200 words. Here, what they're looking for is what are you passionate about and how are you going to contribute to society? You can start from really broad and narrow down to a specific problem that you want to solve and that you're interested in. Make sure to relate the problems with the skill set and knowledge that you gain from the program, how this kind of skill set can enable you to solve those problems in society. Other applications. You can put up to 5 other applications you made to either Cambridge or other universities. It's for marketing purpose, apparently. I only applied to one program at Cambridge, so I wrote some other programs that I applied to at other universities in the order of my highest preference. We've covered most of the general application questions so far. In part 3 of this video, I'll put a link up here, I'm going to continue to explain how to answer the remaining sections on the application form, including course-specific questions. Now let's see an 8-second preview of part 3 of how to get into Cambridge. Course-specific questions are the most important part of the application. Let's use the MFU in machine learning and machine intelligence as an example. I hope you found this video helpful. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up to help the algorithm. If you have any questions or suggestions for future content, please leave a comment down below. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next video very soon. Bye!